up, everybody? What's new in EDU is back in your world. I'm Tony Jackson, and I teach fourth grade in Hackensack, New Jersey. And I'm here at ISTE, where their mission is to bring together people, ideas, practices, and technologies so educators like me can learn all about new updates, features, and game changers in education. So stick with me. I'll show you around, because this is the place to be. Today's job market, 50% of jobs require technology skills. And in the next 10 years, these type of jobs will outpace non-technology jobs by nearly 2 to 1. STEM fields are essential to preparing students for the future workplace. Pioneering STEM curriculum at Microsoft, Karen from the Hacking STEM team has a ton in store for us right over there.
Hi, it's Karen from the Microsoft STEM experience here at ISTE. We're very excited to be celebrating this partnership with BBC Learning and their new documentary, Oceans, Our Blue Planet. We've generated 4 brand new lesson plans that use 21st century technical skills, skills like writing code, building sensors, looking at big data and doing analysis, working with 3D and virtual reality to bring those skills into your classroom. One of those projects that we're doing is a project called How Sharks Swim. We're going to look at that lesson plan in a moment, but note that there are 3 others: how do currents move, how deep is the ocean, and how are corals formed. Let's go look at how sharks swim. Come on. As you can see, the lesson plan begins by first understanding how sharks move in terms of their physiology. So the first thing is to understand the role of those amazing dorsal fin and how the pelota fin and the second dorsal fin work to keep those sharks balanced as they move themselves. The second thing they do is they come in and they actually start to work with a 3D model. That 3D model of the shark is to show that they understand where those fins are. Once they've gone in and done that, they show me that they actually understand the movement of pitch, roll, and yaw. So you can see that we've animated these sharks and we've brought them into PowerPoint. You can see that the student can demonstrate that they really do understand the concept of pitch, roll, and yaw. Now, the interesting thing is that we want to bring this to life with making. But we also want them to be able to understand the mathematics behind this. So students quickly can come in and, using some mathematical models, build a physical model of how those rotations come in X, Y, and Z. And you can see as they start to have this physical model, they can now start to see how the transformation happens in the mathematical plane, being able to reference the physical with the digital experience. The final part of this is to bring this all together into an experience. So they make themselves a digital paper shark. This shark now will go on top of a remote controller or a joystick that they're going to make. So this controller is made out of a little bit of cardboard, some copper tape, some little thread spools, and a dowel. And you can see as I move it, I'm actually being able to test that my shark is moving in pitch, roll, and yaw. Now, I bring it into my virtual marine environment. And as I just drive it along, I can start exploring here, that I'm actually navigating in the ocean environment. Now, the very last thing that happens in this lesson plan, now that we have finished this, is we move this into VR. And as you can see, very quickly, we can now start to have our own shark on the screen. So with that, we'll pitch it back to you, Tony.
That curriculum looks awesome. Yeah, I'm in full teacher geek mode right now, so I can say that curriculum is awesome without being embarrassed. If there was ever a safe space to be excited about education, this is the place. Now, some of those lessons are using something else that gets me really excited. It's one of the most popular video games of all time, turned incredibly versatile classroom resource, Minecraft. Sarah, can you give us an update?
Thanks, Tony. We just released a new update for Minecraft Education Edition called the Update Aquatic. This update is available now and free for all users. We fill the oceans of Minecraft with marine life, shipwrecks, treasure chests, and more. You can now craft coral reefs, you can explore underwater monuments, learn about sustainable fishing, and even swim with dolphins. So our team at Minecraft Education created 17 lessons across school subjects to help teachers get started. The two lessons that we're demoing here are around coding, where you can actually build coral reefs with Minecraft blocks using functions and coding loops. So hopefully you'll come join us. If you're not here at ISTE, you can download the lessons on our website at aka.ms/aquatic. Tony, I'm about to go for a swim, so I'll catch you later.
Thanks, Sarah. Now look, if this is new to you or you want to learn where to start using technology in the classroom, here's my advice. Find something that grabs you and start small. Focus on one thing first. A great place to start is our Hack the Classroom event. You'll get lots of great ideas and inspiration when you tune into the live online event tomorrow, June 26th at 6:15 p.m. Central. Now stick with me this week. We're just getting started and we'll be covering so much more right here on What's New in EDU live from ISTE all week. Make sure to tune in on Facebook at 5 p.m. Central Time every day. Now go learn something. Peace.
See you next time.